Hey everybody, it's Amy from Yo So Boho. Welcome back to another Thursday Night Thrift. Tonight we are at the Chardon Goodwill, Chardon, Ohio. I'll show you the address. First thing I spied when I walked in the door was that 2X 2016 Cavs championship shirt. Irf is a big Cavs fan, was much bigger when we had LeBron, but you know how that goes. It might feel like an eternity ago, but yes, the Cavs won the national championship in 2016. It was an awesome night. We celebrated. And this is an Adidas 2016 NBA championship shirt. And it's like brand new, never worn, half off, great deal. Irf was very happy that I found that. He... of course, loved that t-shirt. It looked brand new. Purple today was the half off. So that t-shirt, I think it said 7-something, was actually half off. So that was a good deal. I went over to the Easter stuff because that's what they have out. They had a ton of these dog banks, so I wanted to check those out. I have not been able to find anything online. So at $6, it just wasn't, I wasn't willing to take the risk on those. Lots of little hand-painted things today, lots of resin pieces. These pieces with the empty eyes were like, first I had to unite them, and second I was like, what's going on there? And then all their babies are up here in a bunch. And I just thought, oh, we're going to walk away. Twink! Lots of hand-painted stuff, and I checked out a few things. This is a miss, I believe. This is a vintage set. I should have checked out the box to see if everything was in there. I just noticed now that it was $5.99 but half off. So for $3, that may have been a good pickup, especially now. That's a cute little piece. Not worth that. Yeah, there was lots of little cute things. This guy was cute. Definitely vintage. Very dirty. Just wasn't something that I decided to pick up. I liked this little piece, and I was surprised when I lifted the lid off and it made that digital music. It was cute. Again, it looked like a hand-painted piece. And I put it down on a lower shelf so somebody else might see it. So what was fun about this day is I was with my mom, my sister, and my nephew, Terrell, and he is hilarious. We got to spend some time together, and here I'm asking him what this is. What is this?
A bell with a Mario ghost on top.
A Mario ghost?
Yep.
It was made in 1998.
Good God.
What do you mean, good God?
The 2000s day, yum yum.
I was like graduating college a year before then. Good God.
Still wasn't born then.
Oh, that guy. I tell you, if I didn't love him so much. We continued to shop together, and where you can't hear him because he's, like a little bit away from me and in his mask, I will put up on screen what he says, but we just had the best time giggling and looking at stuff together. And so this video might get a little silly, but that's okay. Just have to see another side of me. Looking at the baskets, and this was so funny. I'm like, find me a butt basket. And he's like, a butt basket? What do you mean, a butt basket? And sure enough, I turn around, and I kid you not, I find a small butt basket. Like, I say, like this one. And it's dated 98 with a little, I think that was like a CK. So it's handmade. Little egg basket. Now, I would like a nice old big one, but this was a nice little find. Okay, so if you've been watching me for a while, you know I'm on the hunt for a butt basket. This is because it's shaped like a buttocks, this is an egg basket. Now, granted, this is a small one, and it's super funny because I do honestly think it's 86 and not 98. If you look there, it looks like it has that little, you know, little mark there. I can't read the signature from this size. Maybe that's an SG. I have no idea. But it's a nice little piece, and I have been looking for one. I want a big one, and wait until you hear what happens next. I'll leave it for the film part. It's funny. But this is a little damage on it. I paid $3.29. That's a great price. If I was to turn around and sell it, I'd probably ask somewhere between maybe $18 and $22, $24. But I'm going to hold on to it. Maybe I'll list it later in the year, but for now I'm going to probably add it to my spring decor. And that's like a yay. I've been looking for a butt basket and I finally found one. You see any big butt baskets? What's this?
A bigger butt basket?
Not really.
Yeah, that's a flat butt basket.
That's a flat butt. Oh my God. He's hilarious.
I know.
Yep, a flat butt basket. That was my sister, by the way, that agreed that he was hilarious. She will be in some upcoming videos next week. She actually came down for the weekend a week or so ago, and I coerced her into being in the videos, even the haul videos. So you'll get to see her pretty face. So I came over here to my mom's cart because she found this big gold ampersand. And if you watch Tuesday's video, she and I found two large letter R's at the bins. And I said, I need an and because I want to do R and R for the camper. The R's stand for rest and relaxation. Also, they are the first initials of mine and Earth's last name. So, and then I found this cute little kitty and I was distracted. I didn't end up keeping it, but now I have an idea of what I want it to be. Then at the end of this aisle, I spotted this electric ice cream freezer. Those can sell pretty well. Look for the White Mountain brand. They sell for $100, $200. Even the motors will sell for about $80. But that one they had for $15, and I might get $25, $30 out of it, so it just wasn't worth it. Now, if you know, I've had a thing for deer recently, so I grabbed this little lamp. Man, my hands are so dry. I hope you're not watching this on a big screen TV because I could just see all the little flakiness in my hands. So we're walking over now to find a plug to see if this lamp works. I do. I needed your long arms. Oh. Come on, that's cute. Why is there stuff inside the log? Yep, it was cute, but it was also a hobbyist piece. There was all kinds of gunk up in there that was kind of highlighted, spotlighted underneath that little lamp, and it was all chippied up in the front, so I ended up passing on this. Here at the end of this aisle, I found this little Hummel salt shaker. Little girl on there. It's $2.19. I was like, dang, where's the other one? And then we checked out some pots and pans and there just wasn't anything too special here. But on the end cap, after we got through the pots and pans, we found this cute little turtle. It's made in China. I thought it looked like he was nervous and biting his nails. And then look at these guys back here. They're like small mugs, little candy cane handles, and the eyes are like hologram. Oh, let me just show them to you in person. All right, so these are my favorite find by far. And it's funny, when I was laying them out here, I realized that the painting on the faces is different. Like this guy got a little heavy-handed with the self-tanner, and then this guy is like North Pole pasty. They're so cute. Look at the hologram sticker. Makes them like winky blinky. They're very cool. They are vintage. I was able to get the sticker off this one without damaging the under sticker. Made in Japan. I'm having a hard time finding comps on these. I found one single mug that sold I want to say in January of 2018 for about $15. And then I found like four in the box that sold probably later in that year for like $12.99. But nowadays, Christmas, vintage, this cold paint being so, I mean, the condition of these is like beautiful. Anybody who collects vintage knows that red cold paint is like, it just like disappears. But these are fantastic. So my gut says somewhere between $40 and $50. I mean, maybe 10 a piece plus, I don't know. If I get them listed before this video, I will post it up here that it's listed. I may wait a little later in the year where they might sell a little bit better when people are looking for this kind of stuff. But I'm hearing from the rest of the resellers that Christmas sells all year long, so maybe I'll get them up. Okay, back to shopping. You're too young. Put that away. I've been finding the neatest little music boxes. This is cute, just not a lot of value there.
Oh!
I like a crystal, say Mikasa on it. What's the price on the back? $5.49.
This is how it has to be.
Huh?
Oh!
Yeah, that's heavy.
That'd be good.
What is that? What is that red thing back there?
That's probably a cat.
It's a cat, or is it supposed to be a raccoon? Somebody got a little creative with the paints on that one. Liked this piece. Definitely had some cool age to it, had a cool look to it. It really was in bad condition, and they wanted $6.99 for it, so I had to say no.
All
right, bear or hamster?
It's a beaver.
Beaver?
Nope,
never mind. That's a bear butt. Now we're in a new aisle, and look what I find. And I go, ooh, ooh, and I take off running. I'm like, where is it at? Where is it at? Where is it at? I remember it's at. Was it over here? No, no, was it over here? Ah, I think it might be here. Ah, it's here. Terrell's like, what? I'm like, the matching set. I owe you an apology for taking you on that whiplash of a ride. I actually thought speeding it up was easier on the eyes because I was like swinging around and it was a little dizzying without that effect. But these are a matching set of Hummel salt and pepper shakers. They need their cleaning and soaking because I want to get the stickers off. And they still have their nice little plugs in them. These, I'm not sure what they comp for. There's another set currently on eBay in the $34, $35 range. I don't think they'll sell for that. Hummels don't sell as well as they used to. But this seems like maybe a little bit of a harder to find set. So we'll see. I paid $2 a piece, so $4.40 for the set. I'm guessing I'll probably put them on eBay in the mid-20 range and see what happens. I'm going down the wrong way, so don't tell on me.
Oh, you don't get arrested.
Well, I'll be in good company because you already got arrested for it. There's a couple of cool things in this aisle that I wanted to point out. First, these Hummel plates. Plates do not sell. Anyone who resells knows plates just aren't worth picking up. I think those were marked $3.29. You'd be lucky to get $10 for them. Maybe shipping. This is a nice bladder crock. I don't know why I didn't look at the price on that. And then I was excited to see this red Dutch oven down here. It looked beautiful until I opened it. And then I was like, ew. I did not want to deal with that. I have one of these at home, and I know that getting it clean, getting something like that clean, is going to be hard to do. So I passed on it. What's this? These cool, they had little Chinese men like playing instruments or something. Just like the way they were built, they were definitely vintage. I couldn't find anything like them. And this bottom one had some weird crazing around the outside that almost looked, you might see it here, almost looked like cracks. So I passed on them.
Huh?
You sound like Popeye the Sailor Man. I am what I am. And it's all that I am. I'm Popeye the Sailor Man.
Chicken hawk.
pretty funny. Now we're on to the glasses and the mugs, and I see this cool little half mug. You asked for half a cup of coffee. That's pretty clever. Deer Park, Funland.
If you ask for only half a cup of coffee.
That's a vintage piece. Let's look that piece up. We looked it up. It just wasn't worth much. I probably would have gotten it if it was like 99 cents. But for $2.19, I had to pass. And then I zeroed in on this cute mug. Yeah, I had to scoop this. Yes, rescued is my favorite breed. All of my pets are rescued. I always say, please adopt, don't shop. This, I just love the weight of this mug, the look of it, how it has this kind of wonky, I don't even know, molded. I did not look to see what was underneath this sticker. So let me soak it and we'll see what's underneath there so I can do a comp. We're all clean, which is good because there was like remnants of coffee in this. But it is made by 10 Strawberry Street. It is the Pet Lovers Collection. And it looks like one sold on Poshmark for $10. Another one is listed on eBay for $15. I figured it was going to be in that range. It didn't look like a designer mug, but I love the weight of it. I love the size of it, and I'm going to hold on to this. It's going in my cupboard. Finally, Terrell and I headed to an aisle that we missed due to, I think some people were in it, or we weren't going the right direction. I don't remember, but we found these heads, and they were kind of vintage. This one was really grubby, but I did like the way her face and her makeup looked. And I've been finding a lot of hats lately, so I figured this might be a good purchase for me, you know, when I take pictures of some of the hats. Before I get to the last item that we found on that final aisle, I want to point out this piece, this tablecloth. It's probably about a maybe 30 by 30 inch square. So like a small coffee table or side table size. It's embroidered. It's got this beautiful kind of tan on cream, which I love. This flower, it's really clean. I think there was one area like here has a little discoloration on the side, but look at the work and look at this cut work all around the edge. Just really nice. I will get this ironed up and this will go over to the shop. I know if you watch me usually, you usually hear me say that linens do pretty good over there. So I'm going to say probably in the $10 to $16 range on this piece. Just very pretty. This is my taste all the way. Okay, then finally, on that final row that Terrell and I hit, we found these heads. I have brushed her out. I have cleaned her up. She still has this weird, it says 404 on there. I don't know what that was, but she's definitely more clean than she was. And I even think on my photos, when I take my photos, it'll be hard to see that. I have actually used her for photos. I had this hat from Tuesday that I photographed her in for eBay. I just like her face. I think she's got a cool kind of vintage vibe. Her eye makeup is very neat. So just kind of a good prop for me for selling, reselling. I paid $14.99 for her, and I'll put up on screen if I find similar comps. She is vintage. She's Miss Kim. And apparently this is like hair. It said that it was deloused, or no, it was treated so that it was insured not to have any lice in it. So it's for student use. Learn how to cut hair. I don't know. How do you think they did? It's like a layered kind of bob with some bang, I guess. I give it a C+. I can't say anything. I really need a haircut, so. All right, everyone, that is the haul. We had an amazing trip. Super fun to shop with my nephew, Terrell. He's so funny, and I hope he does that with me again. Maybe we'll mic him up next time so you can hear him. Hilarious. My sister, his mom, will be in some upcoming videos next week, so stay tuned for those. And yeah, if you are new to the group, welcome. Welcome to the Yoso tribe. If you are not subscribed, please subscribe. Hit that alarm so you know when I have new videos. Tuesdays, Thursdays, sometimes on the weekend. We may have a surprise haul this weekend, if I can sneak one in. But yeah, please hit that like button, leave me a comment below, all those things, share, so we can continue to grow. All right, guys, take care. I will see you soon.